Matatu is synonymous with Aoraki. It speaks to the mana he holds as the enduring, watchful guardian of all who reside in Te Waka or Aoraki. Kia ora, welcome in to Super Rugby Old Picky 2024, an historic occasion here in Invercargill, where Matatu, for the first time, will host an Old Picky game here in co-commentary. Former dual international Christina Sue. Kia ora.
This will be a classic derby between the North and South, and if last year's results are anything to go by, we'll be in for another thriller.
Yeah, tremendous, the growth, development of the game here in Invercargill over the last 3 or 4 years, and the Matatu team will start Love, Ponsonby and Rule in the front row, Dermody and Bayfield. The two locks, Bremner, the captain, Reynolds and Olsen Baker in the back three, Heaney and McGovern in the halves, Brooker and Duplessis in the midfield, with Mataele, Palamo and Kelly to come out of the backfield, with Lollahair, Parks, Palu, Rort, Grinwig, Jenkins, Joseph, Cormick and Cheyenne Cunningham to come from the bench. The head coach is Whitney Hansen.
As we look at the Blues lineup, led up front is Villecourt, Nungo and Fisher, Blackwell and Vaipulu in the second row, a new and exciting loose forward trio of Ruse, Williams, Guthrie and Moi Moi. Puckett and Cottrell are the experienced halves. Demant is joined by Brunt in the midfield. Kolosi Vahakolo and Maliapu make up the back three. Nagata, Tuli, Fale, Itunu, Lafaele, Mataroa, Cook, Nankville and Miki Miki Vahai round out their replacements. The head coach is Willie Walker.
And sideline today, Ben Castle. Kia ora.
Atalofa, Ken. Kia ora, Christina. No mai haere, mai welcome in to a pretty good afternoon here in Invercargill. The sun was shining a bit earlier, so the wind now has picked up a bit too, but it is a pretty good setting here for the opening round of Super Rugby All Piki. A nice crowd is building here as well. The first time this team here is Invercargill. They had a lovely welcome at the airport. They're getting a good reception here with their crowd turning up, a popular draw card, the locals wanting to see the defending champions, of course, Matatu, up close. But they've got a challenge on their hands, Ken, with the Blues travelling down, pretty good side also.
Indeed, lovely images at the airport when Matatu came in yesterday, as Ruse and Demant, the co-captain, the Blues in 24, 11 Black Ferns and 3 members of the Black Fern 15. And the focus in the off-season has been the acquisition of Niall Williams-Guthrie for the Blues team in the Super Rugby Old Picky after a brilliant and illustrious career at the Sevens game, where she won a silver medal in Rio, Commonwealth Games gold, in a Rugby World Cup medal, Sevens medal in San Francisco. Now spending some time with the Titans in the NRL. Dominant figure in the middle of the park in rugby union and in rugby league. Very impressive lineup, the Blues, and there she is. God, I remember commentating her when she was playing touch football as a schoolgirl many, many years ago. What a career she has had. And now the home team, Matatu, Alana Bremner, very accomplished, intelligent and articulate leader in our game, has done a tremendous job. 10 Black Ferns, 7 members of the Black Ferns, 15 in their lineup. And they are, of course, the defending champions. And outstanding in their group is Amy Rule, the tight head prop. She was a recipient of the 2019 Tania Dalton Scholarship for outstanding young athletes. Out of Upper Emma College and Lincoln University, she's played 20 tests for the Black Ferns. Spent some time with the Brumbies in Australia in 2023. Controversial position in our game these days, referees, but we don't have a game without them. So it will be Mata 2 with first use of the ball. We'll play right to left on your screen. Cottrell, Kristen Cottrell for the Blues, opts to go long. Oh, an error from the kickoff. So this will be, depending on the advantage, a potential scrum with field position as the Blues forwards go to work. Puckett play down the left edge. And now they carry Veliko. Puckett. Again, they carry Moy Moy. Puckett with a flat ball. Cottrell offloads in the tackle. Now they're just inside the 22. Nice controlled start from the Blues. And now a penalty.
Well, Blues have started well. Or from the kickoff with Cottrell. Player with the ball in hand at the moment. Her kickoff was precise with just enough air time. Naomi Rule probably was not expecting that. Be a little bit disappointed, but we need to congratulate Kristen Cottrell for her start.
10 out, left hand side of the park, and Vaipula with a line out. It's a set play. Nangle inside the five. Now Puckett. Now the pick and go, they're inside the 2 metres now, the Blues. What a start. Yeah, they're within touching distance. Bucket. It's going to go back the left side. Bodies in motion, the ball. And if the touch judge was away, he'd have caught that.
Oh, they certainly had opportunities, didn't they, Ken? And I thought they had the momentum of the pick and go. Eruahe probably just has awareness there. Her winger, Colossi, might have held her width there in the five channel. But nonetheless, there's a chance for them to defend.
Ponsonby for Bayfield. And now they carry off the first ruck through Brenner.
Fine play on. She was on there.
Oh, the Blues. In there with some hustle. Great job, and now Williams-Guthrie, 6 metres out. Vaipulu Now Cottrell. Sophie Fisher.
Knock on there in the tackle.
She's been busy early, Sophie Fisher. She was the person that got that steal initially and then went to pick and go. Just who was the person there that managed to collect that ball before falling to her side.
It's all one-way traffic, isn't it, at the moment with the Blues. They've got a great opportunity now to put some more pressure on, but they just haven't nailed those phases, the six phases earlier, and then that great line out. And then on that occasion, just spilling the ball. Now see what pressure they can put through at scrum time. It's a big test up front for both these packs.
Stay up, stay up.
Drops to the right side, off the line, quick Puckett. They eventually scramble the ball out. There's a lot said about this kid, Melanie Puckett, the nine for the Blues.
Oh, she did well to read that and knew it was going to the right side and just smothered the fence. And McGovern's kick there under pressure, almost going backwards, relieved a bit of pressure too. But now Puckett on screen there, she'll be looking for a big game.
The front row of the home team. Yeah, Matatu with Rule, a tight head. Ponsonby, hooker in the middle.
Right. Let's see, ladies. Here we go. There's the middle.
Of course, remember 2022. We're winning Black Ferns, the Women's Rugby World Cup. This was the Black Ferns front row on that occasion. So there's a lot of experience. We've got the up and comers on the other side. Sophie Fisher, a tight head. Already seen her involvement. Villiercourt. Lou said for the Blues, a good challenge for these front rows.
Just bring your feet up under as well, okay? Okay, that's just gone down, ladies. Let's reset.
Liv McGovern. Time of the Exeter Chiefs.
Crouch!
So a defensive assignment for Matatu, 5 metres out from their own line.
Sit!
Shinny. Olsen Baker with a little tip on. And a nice 8-9 play to open up the Blues defence. Matatu from their own goal line. Now another carry. And they're 5 metres short of the halfway on two possessions. Now a long cutout ball for Mataele. Hine under pressure gets the pass away. Now Love. Strong carry, two defenders required.
Turnover was good, but knock on the pickup.
Well, here's a little cameo of how good Matatu can be when they've got the ball.
Yeah, and they're deceptive, aren't they, with that set piece. What you see here is Kaipo Olsen Baker comes off their left side, but it was Grace Brooker who went right. And there's clean breaks, a great regather there from Luke Pasee. Support was in, even though Blues were contesting that ruck then. How strong is she, Olsen Baker?
Yeah, great to see her involvement early, isn't it? Olsen Baker down from Hurricanes Poa last year. Now the new recruit. A really good platform behind her, so powerful. Her time with one or two Cyclones. So you know, Sui.
And you go. Ball's out.
Olsen Baker. Much they can do so. Mataele from a standing start. And then they just lose their way a little bit. Lost 7 metres on the play. Matatu, but they still have the ball. Hini. McGovern. Maliepo. On the kick return, Maliepo loses the ball forward. So there's an advantage now for Matatu Brooker. Hine.
Advantage over now.
Amy Duplessis.
Oh, she had the right idea, the Duplessis. Colossi was up high. There was space in behind. She was able to find it. But both sides have been pressing on defense. Blue side have been rushed and trying to smother the Matatu and disrupt their flow.
Is the middle over?
So both teams just trying to find their rhythm in this opening 10 minutes.
Coming over.
Well, that stat that just came up there, Christina, was handling errors. The Blues, they've got plenty of firepower on attack, but there's five of them, five big ones as well, handing possession back to Matatu. And you can see if you hand, here it is, if you hand possession back to a team like Matatu, you'll be in trouble.
Who's in the middle of a four-man line out and then a little show and go from Demant.
Achilles heel at the moment, isn't it, Ben? Spoke of those handling errors. Set piece was pretty good, and it's just the second touches. And Ruhe Demant did well to regather that, but just probably not aware of that offload.
It just didn't need to go, did it, really? They'd won the ball. It was over the advantage line. Demant could have just taken that in, clean up set again, and then go out to the right or left. And now it gives them an opportunity centre field. They are stacked away to the left. Here, yeah, Rosie Kelly directly in behind the fullback. McGovern and Booker.
Sitting back here with a flat ball. Booker and then a tip on for Mataele.
He's lost forward pass,
take your pick.
Perhaps this is when the leadership will come through from captains. Just try and settle it. Maybe get past a few phases.
Just like this side. Ladies, go, we've got to line up. So go on the line. Yeah. Leave your foot there. Let's go. Because she keeps moving over. Crouch! Binds! Sit!
Come in! In!
Yes! Halfway. Good scrum from Matatu. Puckered with a ball over the top. That's come as a direct result of the pressure applied from Matatu at scrum time. Put the halfback under pressure. Now they make another error. Ball's gone forward.
Yeah, knock on the tackle. Still got your hand on it.
They did well at set piece, Matatu, to pressure them and force them back almost 12 metres. As you can see, Ben spoke about this formidable front row, but there it looked like all eight were in balance and connected and engaged and pushing forward, and Duplessis there with the line speed.
Again, well, it's coming again. It's coming again. They've got a scrum here. They'll get pretty excited about this, and front rowers with the whole pack, really, if they're getting that sort of momentum on opposition ball.
Binds!
Better from the Blues is just a Winston Cottrell with a short ball. Brenner, ball and all tackle on Vaipulu. Cottrell. Nice and aggressive, Olsen Baker. Vaipulu.
We're on our blue. Ball's not out. Leave it.
Strong carries, but good defense. Now they try to get them on the edge. It's knocked down. Duplessis will sit down. Ooh. Good tackle. Reynolds.
Number seven, you're not back 10. Back 10. On the line, thank you.
That is Mal Puckett's trademark. Her quick taps, she did eight of them last season. She almost did about three or four try assists from her quick taps, and I'm sure that's an area of the game that Masatu would have previewed and analysed.
Ball's going backwards, Brooker with a little chip and chase. And Kelly Mataele with there, as is Maliipo from the Blues.
Ella, let's go in when we come.
Nango.
Yeah, if they move, you can move. Yeah.
Yes!
Wasn't expecting the ball. Now they shift, control. Space in midfield for Sylvia's Brunt. First carry in the game. Matatu defends right on the advantage line. Kendra Reynolds. A little half break now, Vahakolo. Exciting young kid in our game, Vahakolo. The mat running outside in, trying to drag some defenders. Cottrell. And the ball knocked down.
See with the Matatu defensive side in line,
I'm happy that
they're leaving the ruck area and they're trying to go forward with line speed. An outward in defense line that's connected. A great run here from Vahakolo. Powerful in contact. Pumping the legs. She's an outstanding player. I think the panel earlier spoke about her being a former Kiwi Fern, rugby league. She's a real asset to our game now in Union.
Yeah, she was a massive standout last year. Didn't see that. World 15 Breakthrough Player of the Year. Mentioned over 300 metres run with the ball. Three tries and a number of line breaks. So this defensive line, but it is pretty impressive the way this defensive line is coming up. But the Blues, they've had the right ideas around there, but the defensive line has got in the way. It's been knock on off Matatu on a couple of occasions. Now see the Blues with two-thirds of the possession in the game. It just shows the defence there, even territory. It's pretty evenly poised. Well, it is. After 15 minutes, both are throwing plenty at it. The opportunities the Blues had early on, Matatu did really well to hold them out.
Grace Ngango in a little bit of discomfort.
Yep, on that mark. It's on both sides, yeah. That's all good. That's all right.
Four-two split for the Blues.
Fines.
There's four on the top of your screen. I've got two on this right side.
Yes,
right there.
Ambitious on the Blues, Ben.
Yeah, well,
move your feet up if it's too.
There's a good hit on this side here.
Yep.
On the Blues, yep, is Sophie Fisher.
Not that far.
She put the good hit on because the penalty, it did.
I'm happy with that. Stay there.
Go against Pip Love on this side because that arm was straight down, so the pitcher was clear. But if Love can just withstand that hitting down from Fisher and then start to drive up, that's when you see the power come on from Matatu.
Coming!
Use it now, nine.
No, there you go.
There's the power from Matatu, and then they take the quick tap because they've got field position. You can see Heaney. Love with a short ball for Bayfield.
Advantage,
oh, then they lose it forward.
Yeah, we're under pressure there. Knock on.
Olsen Baker had the right idea to play, get the ball in play and play. Catch the Blues off guard, speed the game up a little. It was a lovely short ball. Had the right idea to punch that whole Bayfield. The ball from Love. Anyone think she's a rugby league player?
Well, and backing it up after that scrum as well, Christina. They're looking powerful up front, aren't they? You're right, that was a lovely ball and a good line. Just finishing it off, the handling errors. 4-6. Now the pressure's going to come on. This is the side here. Sophie Fisher, the tight head for the Blues, has to hit down. Very tall player. Has to get down low. Reset that, but Love, Love's able to withstand a bit of a hit down from Fisher and then really drive up underneath it. So Fisher's got a real handful here.
Then you guys move up, you guys plant, and they're going to set the gap as well, okay? Yeah, but you guys are going down, and we're not having a stable platform for either side. Yeah, leave your foot there. Leave your foot there.
Gone. No score. It's been a tough, uncompromising first quarter. Puckett from the base with a little chip on, and Vakolo coming on the inside. Olsen Baker. And they might have conceded the penalty, but they're all purpose. At the breakdown, Matatu. Now, Demant in between two defenders, offloads off the ground for Ngangwe.
Play on, turnover's good. Offside number five. Turnover was good, first one there.
The game awareness there, where the ball was. Wondering whether the McGovern go for the points or Rosie Kelly, looks like she will try to get some scoreboard pressure, or is she going for, no, she's going for touch.
Yeah, I think a sideline, there is a decent breeze coming across the ground, favouring the way that she's kicked that ball. It's coming across that grandstand there, but here's just the defence again from Matatu as they come up, and this off a penalty. It's a good line, you can see it out to the top of the screen too, and here's the turnover. Booker, the midfielder, the Blackfern midfielder, great work.
Thompson beat to the middle of the line out. Now they work the ball to the back. Georgia Ponsonby. Heaney. Little back in play. It's a great defense. Very good read from Colossi. In defense for the Blues to force an error. So they start on halfway. With a fresh position, Matatu. Heaney. Georgia Ponsonby taken just behind the advantage line. Love tips it on. Matatu restarting, trying to get some momentum. Brooker. Kelly. Nice little left foot step from Kelly. She can get her arms free. No, she can't. Brooker. And halfback.
Tackle.
Matatu keen to keep the ball alive. Rule with a ball out the back. Duplessis. Bremner.
We're under pressure here. Nine offside, too early.
Well, Puckett's been good with her defensive efforts in the endeavour, but in that time probably just didn't time it as accurately as she would have liked.
Just leave the
table. It was great pressure. I mean, what was a set piece line out on the 22 inside the Blues half, went back to the other half and a bit of a clean break. So we did see an exciting passage of play.
Well, some lovely touches. And look at that footwork, and then again in two hands, and then just
Dignity. Line out win for Matatu. They're just on the 22 line, the middle of your screen now as they drive. Hinet. A nice long ball for Mata Elliott.
Right in the line there of Tash Ganley. Right before her eyes. Seen Liv McGovern a few times try to throw those long balls. Probably had the right idea with two of the Blues defenders chopping in.
Well, I'm far away.
Whoa. Not much in that. Well, you know, referees always right, even when they're wrong. Blues.
Coach!
The priority here would just kick down the other end of the park if they can.
Six! Coming!
Ah!
It's taken back.
Cottrell. Footwork at the line from Cottrell. Then the ball looked as if it went forward, and it did.
See Williams Guthrie there apologising to Cottrell, but she had the right idea. I think it was just accuracy errors there. But as ball carriers, I know the support players need to understand the tendencies and the likes of Demand and Cottrell. She's known for that left footstep, and she'll always look for that offload. And yeah, that was just a bit of almost a balcon. I think Williams Guthrie was going in for a seal or a clean out.
Well, they haven't had much possession in the last 4 minutes, the Blues, and that was their opportunity. And just those 50-50 balls look like Williams Guthrie. There you are. Here's the stat. Williams Guthrie just to clean out, just to reset.
Oh, good scrum from the Blues. Finally, signs of dominance and a penalty advantage. Yeah, you can see them applauding. It has been a tough, tough 24 minutes for them at scrum time. And finally, they make a statement about how good they can be at set piece.
It just shows you there is never an easy scrum. No matter what, no matter who's putting the ball in, you've got to concentrate all eight every single time. We've seen the Blues going backwards and penalised. Well, now it's their turn. Look what it means. This will give them some confidence.
Cottrell on the move. Demant on halfway. Well, the right side again for Vaipulu, who's had a busy day at the office so far. Puckett. And Moi Moi lets the ball go early for Cottrell. Vaipulu this time playing ball for Brunt. Puckett scanning both sides and Veliko. Cottrell with a short ball knocked down by a Matatu player. And then a loose pass. Hine puts the ball in the air.
Yeah, Tanya spoke before about the 50-50 balls, and when they had the go forward and the momentum, perhaps they did need to settle that. Blues, especially since they haven't spent that much time in the opposition's half.
Well, conversely, I mean, last year they were the number one team of opposition 22 visits. So it's just their conversion rate. They've been in there previous. They know they can get in there. They've just got to nail that last bit. So they're even ahead here.
Vaipulu. It's a very, very busy game. Ma'ama Vaipulu.
Sorry, it's a scrum. Sorry, it's a scrum. Not 5 metres, it's a scrum. Thank you.
Well, that would have been a really good variation to their line out head. They pulled it off. Bit of a basic both error if the ball doesn't go five.
For the five. Yeah.
See for Matatu. Now. Winnie Palamo, the right winger. So he's come right outside Liv McGovern out in the back line. Now they're flat. You can see Brooker and Duplessis appearing. A bit more width out to Kelly, but there is Palamo, the right winger, just in behind.
To the line, Palamo now, and a very good read and defence.
He's not on the ball. No hands.
By
no
Brunt.
Hands. Leave it. No hands. Yep, all there.
Brunt's reeled away, and now there's a chance. Kelly, ball in two hands from Mataele. She gets away from Maliupo.
Holding on.
Wow, that was almost like a grass cut tackle. Let's hope that Madeli isn't injured. It's not too bad, but she is limping. A couple of big collisions. There's Brunt. Looks like she may have had a stinger on her shoulder from that big hit that she had on Palimo. As you can see here, read it perfectly. Read was excited to see Palimo with the ball in hand. She's an athlete that's come from netball and basketball and gets a big hit from Brunt. And as you see here, Maliepo, what a tackle. And that is great positioning as well. From Vahakolo over the ball to steal that one.
Move back on the AR. They're moving because you're moving down, so stay there. Stay there.
Come on. Good girl, Bobby. Five in the line out, and again, Vaipulu. Cottrell with a very quick tip on for
Moi Moi.
Sophie Fisher. Cottrell. A tip on straight away and hard and direct at the line. Oh. Uncompromising carry. Now they shift. Veliko. Puckett. They've got some momentum now. It's offside. Mataele.
Oh, where they're going to run with this momentum. It's a double whistle.
They're on attack and you're in the way.
Yeah, cynical. She's been involved, though. Oh, down that side, that run, and then some of the defensive play as well. Oh, the collision with Brunt. Midfielder.
We saw what she could do on defence.
Yeah.
But then her lines and the acceleration and pace and speed, awareness, boom! Bit of a bunt. Oh, and they're both great athletes. Just the balance there. She went low too.
Amatatu in the line out. No score after 31. That's an indication of the evenness of the contest. normally a 10, today playing 12. Dahine, very skillful, tough. Good pass, good footwork, terrific defender. Aaron Puckett, a good contest between the two number nines. Net.
Ladies, let's go again.
Yeah. Oh, you need to wait for the time two.
And it'll be onside. Let's just go again.
And that's great officiating from Tash Ganley.
Yeah, sorry, I was managing the nines on this side, right?
Seen her a few times again in this game, educating the players. And the conversations between her and Puckett, she must stay at the tunnel and not advance until the ball is out. And Dahine, another great at halfback with the awareness to appeal that during the play.
And just inside their own 22, Matatu.
Sit! And you go nine. Play it.
Another good hold. It's scrum time from the Blues against a very impressive Black Ferns front row. McGovern. Malipo, no pressure, comfortable. Carey, now the return. Away from the first defender, offloads in the second. And then the pass not taken cleanly. Well, that's how you play fullback. Malipo, catch the ball on the full. Find yourself a mark and go for it. Here she is on the return.
Oh, just a goosey, the fend, the ball transfer and the offload. She's an incredible, exciting athlete, is Maliapo. Her positioning in the backfield, outstanding. She looks up for space, she can run it, she is a real triple threat. Again, it's just those handling errors. It's been a real Achilles heel for this blue side, and I'm sure when they hit the break soon, that the coaches might have something to say.
Yeah, well, look at that, 15 across the match, 10 to the Blues. The opportunities they've had with the ball in hand, just that they haven't executed. Right now, just gives the opposition another opportunity with the ball. You without it, so you have to back up here. Well, they're down a back, aren't they? Matatu now, so they'll have to string together phases without.
Ladies, come on.
The extra.
We're going to close the gap. All right, both teams are overextending and going down. So keep your feet up close. Leave your foot there.
McGovern, cut out ball, another double miss. There might be a person down on the wing, but they find a way to create some space for themselves. Palamo coming from the right wing, lining up on the left. Very good play, innovative play, double miss. Palamo. She's the right winger, Palamo. She's trying to fend off a Hakolo.
Oh, isn't that an exciting matchup? Palamo's a former track athlete. She's come from, it's only her second season of rugby. She's played netball in the National Netball League, a basketballer. As I mentioned, she's a sprinter. So Bahakolo defended her well in that instance. So we've seen glimpses of what both sides are capable of. Heard from the coaches before, whether it was Carlos Spencer and Charmaine McMillan on the sideline saying, speed it up, speed it up. As Matatu do have a player in the bin.
Well, of course, you go out of pre-season. Hey, where you're playing a few more numbers, the intensity, though, when it comes into competition, it starts to lift. And you can just see the bit of the rhythm of these two teams desperate to get on top of one another. Desperate to throw that first punch, to score that first try, to get the first points. And that sometimes adds a bit of internal pressure, so some of the mistakes is creeping in because there is intensity. There he is, legend himself, Carlos Spencer.
And legend herself, Charmaine McMinniman, next to him.
Yep.
She's doing a bit of coaching herself as well as playing, but some great game and rugby IQ from her as well. And see her in the huddles and throwing in those messages to her side.
Cottrell, cut out ball in midfield for Branta, then a little bit of set deception. Vakolo with a big right hand fend, and now Colossi. Gee, they are good when they shift the ball, the Blues, but what about Matatu in contact?
Team in no hands.
Hine. McGovern trying to buy herself some time and finds a space between Ruse and Maliepo. Maliepo trying to bounce that ball out. Kelly on the half volley. Now the chip and chase, that's off the Blues. And so play on, Vahakolo. In broken play, Kolose. Gets to the ground and now Puckett. Cottrell. Velikor. Release the ball. It's a powerful run from Velikor, then the offload, then another offload from Vaipulu.
No, ball there. Nine-handed roll first.
Oh, some skill. No. In these phases, Moi Moi for Fisher.
Leave it, no hands. Kind of right,
skill. Nice job, Matatu. So good a contact. Matatu, it's the second time line break's been made and they pinched the ball at the contact.
No.
Oh, we're seeing some fantastic matchups and display of some of these talented athletes out there. In that instance, it's her, Kendra Reynolds, that was outstanding in the breakdown. She didn't quite get the ball off her first attempt at getting it, but then went through the ruck and took out the defending players to concede this penalty. Is outstanding stuff from Reynolds.
Yeah, you're right. There it is there, as you're saying, Christina, there it's down. And there's Reynolds having it, getting blown off the ball. The cleanout's not quite there. Stay on your feet, stay in the fight. What a good example, not giving up. And there's the ball, Olsen Baker straight onto it. Matatu. Well, this game across both sides has been physical. Both teams really active with the breakdown.
Bayfield with a line-out win, and nice play back on the inside, Palamo. A little win and away in between two defenders. He net. Now Reynolds, hard and direct with the ball. Kendra Reynolds, he net. Back the right edge now, Bayfield. It's away from the first defender, Fisher. He net. Short ball, Olsen Baker. Powerful carry from the young back rower. Now McGovern. Oh, stolen by Dement. The Blues in the backfield of the Matatu defence now. Inside ball, Cottrell. Tip on Maliepo. Oh, great tackle, Duplessis. That's a huge tackle from Duplessis. Now she kicks the ball to improve the field position.
Oh, these last 5 minutes. There's been some exciting footy. Bit of tip for tat going both ways. Line breaks, big hits, collisions, good steals. The plane on top is a great run. And then that awareness from Demand to stand in the space. Didn't back her pace. Rosie Kelly was chasing, but good support there from Cottrell. And Matatu will never give up, as they've just shown there.
Blues inside their own quarter, but look at this hustle. Brooker off her line quick. Duplessis on the outside wasn't required, but they forced an error now. An inside ball for Amy Rule. And now Matatu. Reynolds. Prominent in the last 10. Kendra Reynolds. 10 metres out. Matatu. Bramner, the captain. Can they convert this pressure into points? Olsen Baker steps out of the tackle. Inside the five now. Heaney. Now they shift to the right edge. Over that ball. Love! We needed the halftime hood up. What pressure. And what a try for Matatu.
Oh, Pip Love showed some patience there. In fact, the whole Matatu side did, even when they heard the hoot up. They were on the sixth phase and knew to keep the continuity, the momentum, the tiring, relentless defence of the Matatu, and they were contesting, but there was just great awareness. The fringe players were too slow, and she just picked and went over the line there, did Pip Love.
Well, two key moments. There was a turnover from Kendra Reynolds. As the Blues came wide, she turned it over brilliantly. And she won the ball back, but it was the one even before that. If you go back to Duplessis, the way she chased back after that intercept, she chased back for her team. You could see her working hard.
Next is added. A wonderful opening 40 minutes, but it's Matatu, 7 points to nil at half time over the Blues. Matatu coach Peter Breen is with Ben Castle.
Thanks for your time, Peter. Well, 39 minutes and probably, 59 seconds it took to wear them down, but you'd be happy?
Yeah, pretty frantic start, very nervous start, had a lot of errors. So I guess the message for us was keep ball in hand, a little bit more composure with what we're doing, and we'll get good results from that.
Your defensive line speed looks really good. I mean, they've had a lot of ball, so you've managed to defuse quite a lot of their attack.
Yeah, defence was a huge work on for us this week, getting bodies in front, being really brave with our contacts, and the girls have really taken to that. It's been awesome.
And set pieces are back yourself. You must quite like watching the forwards do their work, so you can give your back line a bit of space and a bit of ball.
Yeah, we had a fantastic line out launch just then and managed to get through, so they're doing a great job for us.
Good luck second half.
Awesome, thanks very much.
Thanks for your time, Linda. I'm sure there's a lot of talking points at halftime. Can you talk us through a few of them?
I guess it's just making sure we stay calm and be patient with the ball. At the moment, we're chucking 50-50 balls, but we need to do the first job right, which is a good ball carry, set the platform.
Because you've shown out there when you do hold on to the ball, you get over the advantage line. You're nice and physical as well. So there's a lot to like out of that first half.
Yeah, definitely. I think the girls haven't quite tapped into what we can express out there. So I think it's just going back to basics, making sure we look after the pill and get to the right end of the field before we start playing with it.
And our census had a chat at halftime around the set piece as well?
Absolutely. The girls love the set piece. But when you have 15 scrums in the first half, that could take a toll. So we said to the girls, you know, you've got to eat that stuff up because that's part of our job and just get back to business in the second half.
Great, big second half. Good luck.
Thank you.
Enormous amount of defence by both teams in the first half. Well, she's had an eye-catching performance today by Pulu, in the locking position for the Blues. Very active, and now DeMunt from a standing start. Puckett. And the return. Matatu. Palamor. Very good today, Palamor. Both on the right and left edge. Now some ball play from Pip Love, and then some big defence in midfield. Kelly. Doesn't find touch, Molly. But not much angle to work. That's an outstanding kick from Molly Apple.
Could have had all but half a metre to kick that. And did well, and just great awareness. She knew she was inside her 22. She was looking for a bit of territory there, Molly Apple.
Ponsonby for Bremner. Little inside ball from Matatu, so some
take
variation.
Let it go.
Line out time, the ball's loose on the ground.
Yeah, me was on the ground. Let it go.
Might have went against the assist tackler. Might have been my Kawana Kalani Ruse there. Needed to release her. The attacking ball player had a knee to the ground. It's counted as a tackle.
Georgia Ponsonby to the back, and it's collected by Pip Love. And now McGovern with an attack and kick along the ground. Molly Airport partially charged down. It's a good result for the Blues. They'll get the throw at the line out.
Ken, Christina, you'll see Lucy Jenkins out there in jersey 20 for Matatu. She'll be in a loose forward position, powerful player. Played every minute in 2023.
Hustled and then Blues at the drive. Oh, high ball. Hit Fisher on the shoulder, an unforced error. McGovern shifts quickly. Brooker. Oh, Nelly. Good contest between Colossi and Palamo. We've got some wingers in our game. Winnie Palamo, we've got Mickey Vahai to come from the bench.
Before Brooker's kick there, it was Jenkins' quick hands and could have gone either way. Colossi wasn't sure where to go, tackle or go for the ball, but there's nothing in it.
Ruse and Bremner. On the blind side, there they are. Two very important players in the New Zealand game as they go wide for DeMant. She carries, gets over the advantage line. It's a slow recycle. And then an ordinary pass.
It's a scrum. I got in the way.
Tash Ganley's owning that one.
Let's go again.
The official. And then the way there. Thought Puckett was going to go quick off that. We heard from Lindsay Turner at halftime saying she wanted a bit more calmness and composure from her side to play in the right areas of the field. So they'll be looking for the likes of Cottrell, DeMant, Maliapo. All three can kick. See if they can get some field position and territory.
Crouch! Sits.
Puckett.
Clear it.
Oh, the power coming from Matatu. And now Olsen Baker. Big carry. Offloaded in the tackle. But the ball's gone backwards. Big scrum win for Matatu. Now to bear the try. Down the left edge. They just got to keep their head. What a stop, Mataeli. Looked like she was in for all money.
That will be a try-saving tackle of the season. Whoever we need to see the replay as to who came across there and got the hand on the ball.
Moving
into the stadium almost. It showed some lovely passages of play.
Great, thank you. Just checking out the
replay. Mustard too with their catch pass, but we'll be looking at the replay here to get a TMO's decision.
Yes.
It's incredible defence.
Ladies, it's a no try. We're just checking if it's out in the field of play. Line out here or at a goal line dropout, depending on where it is. That's all good. How are we going on those replays?
Oh, what a shot.
Yeah.
Is that Niall?
Colossi?
Yep.
Oh, it's
that's Niall Williams yep. Guthrie. Have a look at this shot. Lines are up. This is a try all day. And no, that is a tackle. Well, I'm going to say tackle of the year, but it's only round two.
Round one. It'll be in there.
Oh, yeah, and for
great
money,
defense.
It's brilliant.
Yep. Great defense. Niall Williams Guthrie.
So got a restart.
Big defensive play. Right centre for the Gold Coast Titans.
I've got the black hand coming
now through. Playing open side flanker for the Blues. Captain of Fitu Samoa in the off season.
I just wonder, Ken, if that ball,
you're
young on a winger, have it on the outside arm because where's that defender coming? Okay, it was cool. In
so
that near arm. See, that's in the near arm here. Put it in the other arm.
Goal line dropout.
Is it a try?
No try.
That's why she's got the reputation and status right in both games. Niall Williams Guthrie, huge play. She's done that her entire career.
Time's on.
Matatu start with a ball on their 10 metre. Brooker offloads in the tackle. For Duplessis, now Palamor. Another good carry from Palamor. Another line break, another three defenders beaten. What a game she's having. Brooker wasn't expecting the ball, but Ruse at the same time. Hine. Now Olsen Baker, what a talent. Now they shift, McGovern. On the 22. He net. For Pip Love. Vaipulu. And a chance, their arm down the left edge. Brooker trying to get away from Demand. He net. So the Blues having to do some massive defence. There's a great offload and now Bayfield. Matatu coming hard at the Blues again. Brooker, tip on. And now Matatu, Mataele. Hine, long ball, Love on the advantage line. Great defence, Ruse. Now they shift. Decoy runner trying to get the ball to the right. Palamor! Winnie Palamor, what a one! What a try, what a build up, and what a finish! Palamor!
This is Matatu at Matatu's best, where they can string together 10 phases, show that composure, show that continuity. The flair, the likes of Brooker, Olsen Baker, you got Dermody in with the clean outs, you got all the front forwards doing the groundwork, and the awareness from Duplessis to give that long ball, that's excellent skills. And though Maliapur did well to chase there, what a great finish.
Well, two big moments there was Mataele, who got them over the advantage line. This is the finish. Yeah, but also Olsen Baker, who's been outstanding in the number eight jersey as well. That was the first punch to get them over the advantage line, to get the Blues defence under pressure. And then it was a clinical finish from this back line.
And they started the second half brilliantly. We have Matatu showing their class.
Well, we've seen an absolutely brilliant piece of defence from Niall Williams Guthrie, and then some brilliant attack from Duplessis. Beautiful cutout ball left to right. And Palamo, what a game she's having.
And that breeze is just starting to pick up here. It's favouring the Blues this half. Potentially a bit of rain on the way.
Mataele hard and direct. Hini. Matatu just going to work. McGovern. Cottrell. Cottrell with a tip on, and now Maliipo trying to get on the outside of Palamo. He takes her over the touchline, and Matatu will get the throw at the line out.
Oh, Palama's been good on attack. We've seen her finish a try. We've seen her have awareness of where the sideline is and being able to use fleet-footed footwork to go infield. And then we've just seen some of her best in defence as well, with some athletes keep an eye on.
Georgia Ponsonby for Bremner. Two in the line-out. Now Dermody. Good defence. Look like she knocked that on. No call from the referee. So Matatu retain position and go to work.
First one there.
Fisher. Two defenders on her. Puckett. And Eloise Blackwell. It's a slow recycle. Vahakolo in close to the ruck, looking for some work. The young winger, Puckett, coming hard onto the ball. Brunt.
And we see what the Blues are capable of when they play that quick rugby, plays on top, generates the momentum.
Blues. Look at this power from the Blues team. And nothing separating these two sides. Puckett shifts. Demand with a ball out the back, and it's going to be a first try. Out on the left edge for Jamie Colosse.
Deserving of that try is Blues. They showed that composure. They had the momentum and they stayed with it through quick taps. They didn't slow it down. They had Matatu on the back foot, and just the awareness and skill set from Cottrell and Maliipo to finish there.
Yeah, nice finish. Kristen Cottrell, she's the one who managed to tap and go. She threw that ball out to Maliipo to finish, but she got the quick tap going, and that put the Matatu defence under pressure, then forced the penalty, that pressure. The quick tap from the experience, there she is, the Farah Palmer Cup Player of the Year last year, Hawke's Bay Tui. And her lovely ball to Maliipo over to Colosse, top try scorer in 2023, so the Blues are not out of this.
Good conversion. The burden is precocious and outstanding young talent.
Oh, okay.
Jamie Colosse, New Zealand Open Touch representative. She was a wing attacker netball out of St. Kennigan College in Auckland. Phenomenal young player. Rouge. And we're back to just 5 points separating these two teams by Pulu. Puckett. Cottrell, if he was looking for Maliepo, but it's Grant out there on the right edge, and they try to square up as Cottrell sends the ball downfield in search of better field position. But it was passed back. So this is good for Matatu. To give them a scrum and good field position.
Althola Itunu in jersey 18 is on for the Blues, replacing Sophie Fisher, the tight head prop.
Ponsonby was looking for Bayfield. It's Auckland who come, the Blues, should I say, come away with the ball. A nice cut out. And Kolesere carries again. Puckett. Cottrell at the line. Cottrell. Three players on the left, and they go for Itunu, then an offload back on the inside for Damant, and now Itunu carries. Cottrell. Nice touch of class for Cottrell. Hang on to that ball as Puckett. No room. Vakolo with an offload. Now the Blues, you get the sense they're about to do something. Maliepo. Offloads for Ngangō, but it's gone forward. He's had some game for Lamo.
The Blues are starting to look dangerous now, aren't they? They're getting a roll on. They're starting to put pressure. There's another penalty from the defensive line. Yeah, once you get a roll on, it's hard for the defence to backtrack. So they're getting some field position. Here's jersey number 23 for Matatu. It is Cheyenne Cunningham. She's on for... Well, here's Winnie Palamo. The game she's had, as you mentioned, Ken. But now their team... onto the park now, Cunningham. The team under some pressure from a fired up Blues team.
So Ngangō, short line out. Ngangō on the wrap around, trying to go inside the first defender, but offloads in the tackle. Blackwell picks up another couple metres on a short open side run. Again, they advance through their forwards, patient. And now a penalty advantage, the Blues. It's been a good last 5 minutes for the Blues. Maliepo.
They spoke it before. Oh no, the deciding scrum or penalty tap.
Oh, they're going to use their power game, and it's used, the co-captain, with the first carry. A pick and go on the second. They're just short. Now they're a big chance, the Blues. Good low body position. Now they go to the right edge. Cottrell, what a show and go. The pressure put by the forwards and the finish from Cottrell.
Oh, that's her trademark. She knows how to give the ball wide or do a show and go, little right foot. But this Blues forward pack have been impressive. They've been connected. They're doing the groundwork. They're ball carrying. They're cleaning rucks. And then they're allowing these backs to finish, all due to the work that they've been doing up front.
Well, lovely footwork from Cottrell at the end, but this is out of the penalties, really. That's going against Mata too. There are 12 penalties now, counting against them, and they've been the recipient of the last few. But it's also the offloads are starting to stick for the Blues. Some of that role, some of that halftime discussions they've had with their coaching group around being accurate with the pass, it's got them over the advantage line. It's got players like this, Cottrell, the try scorer, in plenty of space and options, going over for another good try. Good response from the Blues.
Smart conversion as well. 14-12. Plenty of time on the clock. Put Love, Carey. Now they both forward running on the outside shoulder of McGovern. Now an inside ball. No halfback. Rule goes there. Brookar with a cutout ball for Mataele. Blues with some purpose at the breakdown. Oh, good offload and the tackle there. A chance down this right edge. They lose the ball forward.
Oh, Bremner will be disappointed with that, but Pip Love just been able to identify Nano in front of her, give the pass, the ball skills from this Mata 2 side. I tell you what's impressive is the clean outs, it's the ruck work at the breakdown. Often viewers and people at home may just watch the person with the ball and what's happening. But actually, if you look at what's happening around the ball, the amount of collisions and physicality at the breakdown, it's been impressive from both sides.
I totally agree, Christina. Some of the players being first round of Aupiki, throwing everything into it. We've seen the collisions out wide on the wing and in the close quarters you mentioned around the breakdown, and here is a replacement. There's Nungo, the hooker, right, she's leaving the field. We have Nishiho Nagata on debut here in the middle of the scrum.
Wonderful to see Nagata out there for the Blues. It's the Japan hooker, coached by Leslie McKenzie, former international hooker herself, and good exchange program. Moi Moi Puckett into the midfield. They got bodies in motion. Ball's gone to ground. Demand plays halfback. An inside ball, Blackwell. Tunu. Big carry from Tunu. Now they shift to the left edge. Roos. Oh, great steal. Great job at the breakdown, Mata 2. That is a big turnover. Now Bremner.
Right, let the ball come, let the ball come. All there.
Now Ponsonby. Brooker. And McGovern for Cunningham. It's Brooker at first receiver. In and out. Amy Rule hard and straight. Love. Ah, Duplessis, no room, forced to take the line on herself. Now Hine, back the right side. Brooker, McGovern, Bremner. Right foot step and a fend from Bremner. 25 metres out, Manatu, building pressure. And now Kaipo Olsen Baker. Now they advance. Ponsonby. Now they're in the middle of the park and go left or right. They go to the left. McGovern. A late ball over the top. Cut out by Mataele. Back on the inside. Williams Guthrie with a tackle again. Now Duplessis. Matatu. 5 metres out. Now they shift. Olsen Baker. Olsen Baker. What a run.
Back.
Now the recycle. Hine. Brooker. Short ball. McGovern. Now Amy Rowe. Back on the inside. McGovern. Grace Brooker. There it is. Converting the pressure into points. Grace Brooker.
Oh, what a try. And what a team performance that was. Probably the most phases in the game. They went all the way over to the left edge. They got defended well from the Matatu, our blue side, and just showed the good hands and support, leg drive, getting around the corner, and Grace Brooker, she's been good all day.
Yeah, just 13 phases, Christina. And it took this team to break them down. It shows the quality of defence in the second half, but the way that they've been patient, the way they've chosen their opportunity, but you said it as well, Christina, coming around the corner, putting pressure on the defence, beating them around that edge. And it shows the energy getting around, and they had to respond. The Blues were throwing everything at them, and they've come back, this Matatu team. There's substitutions there for Matatu in jersey 21. It was Maya Joseph. She has gone on for Dai Hine. And also Marcel Parks in jersey 17 on in the front row. And Cheyenne Trudefale on debut in jersey 17 for the Blues.
Cunningham. And Marcel Parks. Good first carry from Parks. And now to the left edge, Matatu with a tip on. Bremner. Not able to take the pass.
7 and 7 black.
No more substitutions here for the Blues. This is Taufito Lafayele in jersey 19. Making way into the park, jersey 19 also for Matatu. It is Holly Rat Hoingwick.
There's 7 black off though.
Say that again, Ben.
Thanks. Come on, guys.
Lafayele.
She's a good player, Holly.
My ball.
17-14. We had one try in 40 minutes. We've had four tries in 26 minutes. In the second half, they have gone play for play.
We're just going to wait. We've got new props on.
And what has
we're
been
wait till we're still in stable before
an enthralling and entertaining contest since the get-go. And on the subject of Southland Rugby, 4 years ago they had a six-team, 10-a-side competition. And in the curtain raiser to this game, Midlands played Marist. They now have six full 15s teams playing here. The growth and development of the game here in Southland and the women's has been fantastic. And this game is part of that process as well. As the Blues. Cottrell with a kick in. behind, and now Kolosi offloads in the tackle. Maliupo, strong. Sheba offloads the ball back to Kolosi on the 22 now. Cottrell with a tip on for Lafayette. Now they're inside the 22, and it's stolen again by Matatu. An offload from Hini. And quickly they get to the left edge. What a game you're having today. Hini. Now they carry. Now the shift. Amy Rule at second receiver, can't do much.
Take him back.
Joseph. Good offload and the tackle. Cottrell.
No, leave it. Leave it.
Oh, the intensity and the pace of this game has certainly accelerated and increased. Lafayette's involvement has been exceptional. The impact players is going to be crucial these last 12 minutes.
Another substitution here for Matatu. Atlanta Lolo here. They're facing Georgia Ponsonby. Good afternoon from the hooker for Matatu.
Lolo here. Brooker. Maybe a chip on, but the defense hold it up in midfield. Lafayette.
Turnover's good.
Over the ball, Lafayette.
Blue off. Let it go.
So the Blues with a steal. Itunu with a little chip on, and then an offload for Blackwell. Gets it away. They've got a 2-on-1 down that left side. Kolosi heading towards the post. And she gets her second try.
Well, the viewers at home, if you've only just joined us, you will not be wanting to leave your seats in the TV screens. We have some game on our hands. 11 minutes to go. It's going tip for tat. The last time these two sides met, there were only 3 points in it. And just the passage of play, Cottrell's been absolutely influential today. And Kolosi, look at that running stride. Athlete.
Well, three tight forwards involved in that handling as well. Aldora Utunu, number 18. And then Eloise Blackwell, one of the most experienced. Blackfern, and then out wide Cottrell, again summing up the situation and unleashing the try-scoring machine. Kolosi, oh, what a second half it's been from the Blues. They were 0 points going in to the shed.
I reckon it's all that heavy defence in the first half. Taking its toll on both teams, and it's turned into unbelievably entertaining contest in the second half as Cottrell, with a bit of pressure being brought to bear on her, pushes the ball out to the right, and now it's the Blues by two, and this very talented athlete, Jamie Kolosi. Touch, netball, and rugby union. She's doing it all with style and class.
Tight head Amy Rule is being replaced by Wumunga Palu in jersey 18.
Kelly, kick off. And Lafayette. Immediate impression from the bench from Lafayette. Blues just inside their own half. And the Matatu defense trying to fly out of the line. Put them under the pump. The shift, Cottrell. Demand. Brunt. Brunt tips the ball on Maliupo. She's run down from behind, but brilliantly gets the ball away in the tackle. The Blues again with the hot hands. Now they come right Tuli Fale, 7 metres out. Oh, and here are the ball. It was around Moi Moi's ankles. Not able to get a clean grab on it.
Oh, this game is so entertaining. Brant, man, I don't know what she's been doing in the off-season, but she looks a lot faster. And just that awareness, able to give it. The likes of Kelly, though, they will never give up. Brooker over the ball. She's probably lucky not to get a penalty there. And just relentless defence from this Matatu side.
Now, that's the second time we've seen the desperation work of Matatu on defence. That was a brilliant break by Brunt, the midfielder. But the way that Matatu team, it shows what a quality side they are, the champion team they are. With that line back to get back, desperate tackles, defending their line.
Olsen Baker away from the first defender, offloads and the tackle of the second. Now Brooker.
Yeah, but you're done off.
It's Olsen Baker. This kid's only a couple of years out of school. What a game she's having in the professional level.
Got the penalty advantage.
Number two. Down by two. Looking for some space on the right edge. There's the tackle. Cunningham. Somehow stays in the field of play and then rolls. What a game.
That's good officiating there. She had no real other option to Cunningham. The support was slow. The defenders were looking like they were going to smother that. Just good awareness there, or good officiating from Tash to award that penalty for the extra roll.
Number 8, Black.
Here we are, number 20. Going on for the Blues. That is Paris Mataroa on debut.
Momonga Palu out of Hastings Girls High School.
Time back on.
Played for the Hawke's Bay Turi as an 18-year-old in year 13. Came down to Christchurch 2 years ago, Black Ferns 15. Last year is Matatu. Through Lula here, coming from behind. The time ticking away on the clock. They've got to go for it, and they do. Finding some space on the left edge.
Tackle!
Now Palo puts the ball down. Big ball runner she is as well.
Oh, and if she had caught that ball, it would have been dangerous because she was aiming and targeting that advantage line. But they'll look to reset, focus on the next movement. She's got a great team around her to support her. What a game we have. These next 4 minutes are going to be crucial. Almost could go the weekend.
Oh, 3 minutes and 50 seconds. The Blues need to hold on to the ball and stay down the Matatu end of the ground.
Coach!
Matatu.
Fines!
State the obvious, they need a try. So contrasting six agendas in these closing minutes. Demand with a cutout ball for Maliepo. And now Colossi. Fends away Cunningham.
Ball was out.
Puckett with a flat ball and Lafayette with another carry. Short ball, Vahakolo coming from the wing again, looking for work. Tuli Fale. Cottrell, runner coming on the inside. Vahakolo, one-on-one with Kelly. Thought about an offload, couldn't free the arms up. Dement, flat ball on the left edge. Oh, Lafayette couldn't make the pass. Now the pick and go. Desperate defense. The Blues trying to close it out. Just a meter out, a big strong carry. And the try's gone. Wonderful finish, Lafayette. big impression from the bench and a big play in the closing minutes.
It was a big moment and a massive play. The likes of Puckett has been incredible today, the way she leads her troops. And the wingers that go looking for work before this try was Vahakola's line break. Just have been clinical, a well-deserved try there, Blues.
Well, they talk about it's a 23-player game. And in jersey 19, Lafaeli, who started from the bench in this second half, where the fresh legs have come on. She's been brilliant in the carry. She's been involved in a try down that left-hand side with Colesi earlier on. So she's got stuck into everything, exactly what you need from your bench, and especially what this game needed from the Blues as well. They had zero on the board at halftime. They're 24 points now. What a brilliantly taken try. It's been some special rugby from the visitors.
30 seconds. Hello. Well, they were down 7-0, the Blues, and they were down 12-0, then they were down 17-14. And they've stayed in the contest, competed hard. Short kick. Yes, it's just gone 10. Oh, converted. Try will force extra time. The Lahia
out of it. Thank you. Yeah.
Another shift. Hooker, it's knocked down deliberately. Lafaeli. Referee says no sin bin.
Yep.
Mata two. Parks. Palu. Palu! Oh, got through the defence, but a second error. And now Ruse, the co-captain, the runner's coming. There's the final hoot up.
We have time for a line-out. If you kick it out, it's a line-out.
So they got time for the line-out. The hoot is gone. So the Blues need the ball. Mother 2 need a miracle. That's it, one play left. And it's their throw at the line out, just their side of halfway. Given the kind of contest it has been, I wouldn't be surprised if Mata 2 find a way. And Parks and Lola here, little committee meeting. And Lola here for Bremner. Brooker, Palu. Third carry, splits the Blues defence, Palu. That's why she's out there. Now they're in the Blues half.
No, let it go.
Cormick, shifts, Brooker. Blues trying to find a way to hold on, shut this game down. Now Vaipulu with a tackle. Now they shift. Mata 2, right foot step from Duplessis. Duplessis in some space. Gets the ball away in a tackle. Puckett with a big defensive play. Now they shift. Mata 2. That four-man overlap on that left edge. Palu. Palu. The man tried to stop her in her tracks. Lola here, 8 metres out. Cormick. Now Mata 2. The Blues need to find a way. Mata 2, they've got the ball. Parks. Bremner. Where's Palu? They need to get it back behind the ball. Lola here. They drive them back. Matatu. Palu's in position to carry. Palu. Taken and a big tackle. Tuli Fale.
Wow.
This is not over. There's a oohs and ahs happening at home.
What's your call, Christina? You're the captain here. What are you doing?
Oh, feed Cripe Olsen Baker. Get to Golden Point.
Olsen Baker. Big charge at the line. They've got bodies around the ball. The Blues, they recycle. Palu! Palu! Momonga Palu! She's held up. They hang on. What a game. What a contest.
That's it.
And what a finish. The Blues, absolute stunning performance. To win by 24 points to 17. And all in the hands of young Momo Ngāpalu. Sport can be cruel. And if there was ever a game that didn't deserve a loser, it's this one. Absolute. Tremendous performance from both sides. Just the one try in the opening 40 minutes. And then six fabulous tries in an entertaining second half. We've seen some games, Christina Sue. This one's up there.
Oh, this was an exciting game, and the likes of Palu, I mean, she was outstanding, and I know there was just inches in it. It's the defence that was relentless. Ruahe Demant, you got the Black Ferns that are scattered throughout, the likes of Rosie Kelly, Brooker was massive, Puckett, it could have gone either way, and this is rugby, and this is the entertainment, and this is what we need for our game.
Maya Ruse, the captain of the Blues, is downstairs with Ben Castle.
Yeah, thanks, Keno. I'm with Maya. Wow, what a second half from you guys. I guess at halftime, did you think this was possible?
Yeah, we had belief from the beginning. We just knew we needed to take our time, maintain our ball, and play on top. And I think we expressed that, and we just had some more patience in the second half. So, yeah, came around.
Yeah, so the second half was far different, wasn't it? The way you hung onto the ball. Some of those passes were sticking, the ones you were forcing beforehand and getting over the advantage line, and some of the physical defensive work. So a really complete second half.
Yeah, I'm proud of my girls. We've been working really hard in the preseason, and so it's cool to see it come together.
And this is a tough Matatu team. I mean, they're the champions, right? So coming down here, a long way to travel, you're up against it. But I guess in the first half you were, in the second half shows how a quality side you guys are.
Yeah, the crowd down here was awesome. They had their 16th man, 24th man on the field. And so I guess it was just a mind game for us. We played hard, we kept it nice, and results came.
Well, congratulations. I guess the first tick on the box of the season. So I'm sure it's going to be a tough one, though. So you roll on next week.
Yeah, on to the next. Thank you.
Thank you. Alana, I was... a tough one, wasn't it? That first half was a real grind, wasn't it? Your defence was put to the test, but that's what that first half was on. You scored at the end. What was the message at halftime?
Yeah, you're right. That first half was a grind. The front row up the front, man, there were a lot of scrubs out there, but that's also momentum going into the halftime, getting that try. And, yeah, we just needed to stick to our processes, control that tempo, and I couldn't have asked for more effort out there.
Well, we sort of said in commentary that it's one of these games, you know, sport can be cruel. It's one of these games where having a winner and a loser is really tough because you're both teams threw so much at it. It was pretty physical, wasn't it?
Exactly, very physical. And these are the type of games that make Super Rugby Opiki so exciting. We had a lot of deep shots out there today across all four teams, and that's just exciting to see how far this competition has grown.
You can see that second half, some of the skill level that's out there being demonstrated, the kicks that are scored, that are collected and in the corner, and the debutants contributing, and it's all done with a smile on the face. I mean, this is game one, so there's a long way to go as defending champs.
Yeah, it's very exciting. Only game one, we've still got
hopefully six more to go to showcase our skill and come together stronger. But yeah, the atmosphere here, Southland really turned it on for us and gave us the extra 10% out there on the field today.
I know you've enjoyed it down here. You'll be disappointed with the result, but I'll let you go back to your team now and regroup next week and go well rest of the season.
Awesome, thank you very much.
Oh, a wonderful game for all of us to enjoy wherever you're watching here in New Zealand or around the world. Thrilling 24 points to 17, the Blues over Matatu.